Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel once again. For those of you who are new to the channel, my name is Christian Edgar, and this is a channel that is all about architecture mostly and engineering plus real estate. So in Africa. Now in today's video, we are going to look at an apartment block, and this apartment block consists 8 units. Actually, we're going to look at 2 apartment blocks. One has 8 units and another one has 9 units and a terrace on top. Yes, but all the units that are on this apartment have got a single bedroom, a living room, plus an open kitchen setting, which is just enough, plus 2 balconies, both for the living room and the bedroom. Yes, it also has a toilet, by the way, a toilet and a bathroom inside. Yes, the bathroom, the shower area has a shower cabin. Yes. So I would like you to stay tuned to the end, because there is a lot that you're going to see when it comes to how much you can do with a 50 by 100 plot of land that is 12.5 decimals. For those of you who have a 50 by 100 plot of land and want to venture into residential real estate, yes, you can start with that and do a lot with it, because it's actually big and it can accommodate 8 units, which have single bedroom, living room, kitchen, you can imagine. And then you earn good money out of it every month and annually. So I'd like you to stay tuned and watch this video so that you can see how much you can do with the 50 by 100 plot of land. Yes, because in this video, we are going to show you how possible it is and how much you can do in case you want to venture into residential real estate. Yes, with the 50 by 100 plot of land. Yes, so we are going to see this apartment, we are going to look at it, and then we are going to see how we made it possible for this apartment block to fit on a 50 by 100 plot of land, and we still add ample parking space for all the units that are on the apartment block. Yes, so I'd like you to stay tuned to the end. Okay, so this is our apartment block, and what we're looking at is the ground floor apartment. Now, we are going to look at the functionality of one unit, because all units are identical to each other, all units are similar. So, on the ground floor, we have 2 units. This is one unit and this is the second unit. Now, in the middle is where the staircases are that we use to access each and every unit. So on the ground floor, let's get into one of the units and then see what we have. So this is the ground floor of our apartment, and entering this unit, let's look at these units because they are all identical. So we access this house from this door. So you get to the staircases, then come, then access it from this door. Now entering, we get into the living room. Now the living room the space is really enough, because you can see we have our sofa sets rearranged well. We have our sofa sets arranged well, and we still have a space where we can put the center table. Then also this is where the TV area is going to be. Then you can place your fridge here, right here, close to the this mini kitchen. Now the mini kitchen is an open setting, as you can see. Yes, it's just enough for someone who is starting up a life, those fresh graduates from the university. Well, so you can see the kitchen is right here. You have an oven where you can do your cooking stuff. Yes, and besides the kitchen, we have a door that helps you access the balcony area. Now this is a living room balcony that is facing the front elevation of the house. Yes, so that is it for our living room. Then now, after the living room, we have an open door. This open door leads you to private areas. Now these private areas, okay, when you enter this open door, you get into the corridor. Yes, we designed the corridor for you here, where you can put your stuff. Maybe you come in with some simple stuff. You can even put shoes, you can put anything. It's just an open corridor for kind of a store.
So now when you enter this side, we have our bathroom and toilet area. Now this bathroom and toilet, they are all in under one room, but what we did is to petition the bathroom and give it a shower cabin with which has frosted glass. Yes, so that in case you have a visitor and the visitor wants to use these washrooms, he just gets in, comes, uses the toilet, and then washes his hands and then leaves. He doesn't have to peep into the bathroom. You as the host. So the fact that it has frosted glass around, yes, that's it. Simple settings. Then after that, right opposite, we have the door that leads you to the bedroom. Now the bedroom has wardrobes. Yes, you can see the wardrobes. It has wardrobes. Yes, it has. Yeah, the space is enough. It's enough. It's really enough. It also has a door. Now this door leads you to the balcony. Yes, because it has a balcony of this one, because of its own. In case you want to get some fresh air, sit around and read your novels, yes, all those things, you can just come here then sit. So your tenants are really catered for. They have that luxurious life. Yes, so they can sit here and then read their novels and also get some fresh air. Yes, so that is it for each and every unit. Now right behind here, this is the duct, because when usually when for us we are designing buildings, you don't like to leave those drainage pipes running on the surface of the wall, because they make the wall of the house look very, very untidy. So what we do always is to provide a duct both for the drainage pipes and also the electrical wires that may be running on the surface of the wall. So that's it for every unit. Now just as we have looked at this unit, that is how all units are going to be. Yes, on each and every floor, because each floor has got to 2 units. So this is just the ground floor of our apartment block. All right. So now let's see how we can position this block on a 50 by 100 plot of land. Then we also see the parking space, all those things. So this is how it will literally be when it is positioned on a 50 by 100 plot of land. Not forgetting the building regulations that require that we leave 1.5 meter away from the boundary wall, which we have followed properly. Yes, as you can see. So everywhere, yeah, this is well planned. So it's best that you get a good architect in case you want to plan for your piece of land, because it will help you a lot and save you a lot. So this is, by the way, for information, this apartment, yes, covers an area of 135 square meters. For those of you who are engineers, you know what I'm talking about. So that's it, and the parking lot is right here. Yes, we have 8 cars already parked in the parking lot. Yes, so that is it. Then also, by the way, on a 50 by 100 plot of land, still 9 houses can fit. Yes, 9 houses can fit. Now, if you're to put nine units, then that means you have what you call a 50th floor. Now, on the 50th floor of your apartment block, you'll only have 1 house and then a terrace. Let me show you what I'm talking about so that you can really see. So this is it. If you've decided to have 9 units on your apartment block, that is how it's going to look like. Yes, it will look like this, and this is how it will look like. Yes, it will have 1 unit, yes, on the topmost floor, which is the 50th floor. Then you'll have a terrace right here, yes, where people can sit in case the people can sit and relax a bit. Then this area, you can put your water tanks right here for all the apartments. Yes, so that is it. Yes, with good planning, yes, you always have the best of it. So this is it for an apartment that has got 9 units on it. Yes, it has 5 floors. This is floor, ground floor, first floor, second floor, third floor, fourth floor. Yes, so that makes it 5 floors. So that's it. Then let's see the one that has 8 apartments on it. So this is the one that has 8 units on it. Now, which it has two units per each floor. Let's look at it and then see. So this is how it will look like, and this is also okay. Yes, so you can see how it is. This is the ground floor, first floor, second floor, third floor. Yeah, that's it. This is the apartment that has got 8 units on it. Yes, you can see that cars are parked well and there is really enough space, circulation space. Yeah, so that's it. And now right now let's head into how much a developer is likely to be earning. That is, they have decided to build this apartment with one bedroom and a living room. Let's see how much the developer will be earning monthly and annually. Yes, if the developer has decided to build such an apartment and he has decided that he's going to build 4 floors and each floor has 2 units, which makes it 8 units. Let's take an example that the developer has decided to build such an apartment which has got 8 units in areas like Kisasi, Chanja, Chibwatule, Najera. Yes, such units will go for 700,000 each unit monthly. Yes. Now if he has decided to charge 700,000 monthly per unit, you will be earning 700,000 from each unit, which is an equivalent to $179. Yes, that is monthly from every unit. But out of the 8 units, you will be earning 5.6 million shillings, which is an equivalent to $1,435 monthly. That is out of all the 8 units that he has, in case he had decided to charge 700,000 per unit. So now annually, if he's deciding to charge 700,000 per every unit, annually he will be earning 8.4 million shillings from each and every unit on this block, which is an equivalent to $2,153. Yes. And annually he'll be earning 67,200,000 shillings. That is annually from each and every unit on this block, which are 8 units, which is an equivalent to $17,230. Yes, so that is how much the client will be earning annually and monthly. Yes, if he's deciding to build these 8 units of this apartment block. Yes, now, okay, let's say that the client has decided, oh, minimum charge 500,000 per unit on my block. Okay, so if he's deciding to charge 500,000 per unit on every block, that means he'll be earning 500,000 Ugandan shillings on every unit, which is an equivalent to $128 currently. Yes, and out of the 8 units, he'll be earning 4 million Ugandan shillings. Yes, which is an equivalent to $1,025. Yeah, from all the 8 units. That is, if he's deciding to charge 500,000 per a unit, which is an equivalent to $128, that is monthly. Yes. So he'll be earning 500,000 from every unit, and he'll be earning 4 million shillings from all the 8 units monthly. Yes. Now, annually, yes, the developer will be earning an amount of 6 million Ugandan shillings from each unit. That is annually, yes. And then, which is an equivalent to $1,538. Yes. So from all the 8 units, he'll be earning 48 million Ugandan shillings if he's deciding to charge 500,000 monthly. Now, 48 million Ugandan shillings is an equivalent to $12,307. Yes, so that's it. No, so that's it. So as announced, so that's it. So you can really see that you having a 50 by 100 plot of land in this Uganda is not a joking subject, because you can really earn a lot from it. That is, if you get the right architect to help you develop your piece of land. Yes, and make proper utilization of all the space that you have. Yes, you can start with this and become a millionaire and a billionaire in real estate. So that is it. So in case you want to know, so we'll be breaking down the cost of this apartment in time to come. Yeah, in case you need to know how much this apartment can cost you, how much this apartment can cost you for you to build it, You can get into my inbox, then you can talk and see. Yes, so that is it. Thank you very much for watching the video. And if you're new to the channel, please don't forget to hit the subscription button. I remain Christian. God bless you.
Yes, and now thank you very much for watching. And then also, in our next video, we will also have another video whereby we will look at a two-bedroom apartment, a two-bedroom unit, yes, on a 50 by 100 plot of land. So keep following so that you don't miss out on this episode. Yes, we'll be looking at how many units of two-bedroom can fit on a 50 by 100 plot of land in time to come. So keep following and watch. Thank you.